Thank you very much.
Bonjour from Münster and hello Jill. And of course, many thanks to the organizers. The heading optimal vector quantization of my talk is taken from electrical engineering and concerns the quantization, the space discretization of random vectors or its distributions. In the mathematics literature, it occurs since about 25 years. And I will present some new results or some decisive improvements of known results in this area. And they are part of a forthcoming, hopefully forthcoming, joint book with Jill on quantization. Something does not work. Okay, here's the outline. I will introduce the quantization problem. Then I speak about non-asymptotic bounds and sharp asymptotics of quantization errors, the geometry of optimal quantizers, random quantization, and perhaps about empirical quantization and greedy quantization. So here's a problem and several things you will recognize from yesterday's talks. So let E equipped with a norm be a Banach space, typically a function space. Let X be an E-valued Radon random vector with distribution P. That means that that probability of any Borel set can be approximated by the probability of compact subsets. Let R be any positive number and assume that the R's strong moment is finite. And then for any natural number, the quantization problem consists in minimizing this LR norm of the distance of X to some quantizer gamma over all these quantizers, these N quantizers or N code books or N grids that are simply subsets of E with at most N points. Then the LR minimal N quantization error is given by this inf over all errors over all quantizers of size n, and such a quantizer is called LR optimal. It attains this inf, and the sequence of n quantizers is called asymptotically LR optimal if the error of these quantizers is strongly equivalent to the minimal quantization error. That means the ratio goes to one. Then if gamma is any N quantizer, the Voronoi quantization X hat gamma is this nearest neighbor projection. That means the following. Consider the Voronoi cell VA with respect to gamma consisting of those X which are as close to that point A than to any other points from gamma. These cells are not pairwise disjoint. So one makes them disjoint by a Borel partition consisting of cells CA with a pairwise disjoint and contained in VA. And then XZ is the nearest neighbor projection A. One can check that the error of gamma is the same as the error of the quantization. So that's the minimal quantization error, maybe described as the inf over all these quantization errors of Voronoi quantizations. These Voronoi cells are rather complicated objects, depending on the norm. However, in case of a Hilbert space or in case of an Euclidean norm, they are convex. There are even finite intersections of closed half spaces, and thus, in this case, rather regular. Here are some pictures that are, I guess, 34 points in the plane. And it's with respect to the L2 norm, the Euclidean L2 norm in the plane. And you see that the Voronoi cells are polygons, convex, even the bounded cells are polygons. That's a two-dimensional standard normal distribution and an L2 optimal n quantizer with n equal to 500. And here you see that most of these inner cells are hexagons. That's not by chance. And as I will demonstrate a bit later, the radius of the ball around these quantizers is about 5. So more theoretically, it's 2 times the square root of log n. So here's another interesting picture concerning the Brownian motion. That the Brownian motion at time 1 and the sup of the Brownian motion over 0,1. And here again, you see these hexagons. As I said, this is not by chance. And here is a functional quantizer that is the random vector is Brownian motion, seen as random vector in the L2 space over 0,1. And n is equal to 30. And here, these quantizers come from the eigenfunctions of the Brownian motion. More precisely, one can show they are linear combinations of the first 3 eigenfunctions. And these eigenfunctions are sine functions. So they look like this in the inner part. And these outer guys come from the first eigenfunction where the sine has no full period in 0,1. Of course, they are very smooth in contrast to the Brownian path itself. So now I concentrate on the case, on the finite dimension case, is equal to RD. You can read this above. So the minimal quantization error goes to 0. That's no problem. Existence of optimal quantizers is also no problem. Furthermore, the quantization problem may be seen as the minimization problem with respect to the LR Wasserstein distance, or Kotarovich distance, WR. And here the inf is over all discrete probabilities with at most n supporting points. A construction of X can be done with any sequence of quantizers where the error goes to zero. Then the Wasserstein, the LR Wasserstein distance between T and the distribution of the Voronoi quantization. That means this is the distribution of the Voronoi quantization. That's a weighted empirical. The weights are the probability of the CA cells. And this distance goes to zero. So in this sense, these weighted empiricals reproduce the original distribution. And the point density measure is a bit different. Assume that this absolutely continuous part is not zero. And assume that gamma n is an asymptotically optimal sequence of quantizers for x. Then the standard empirical, so the 1 over n weighted empirical, goes to some measure PR weakly, where PR has a density HR, that is H to the D over D plus R, up to some constant. Provided P is a so-called LR shadow distribution, which I will explain a bit later. So this density plays a rather important role in this theory. And as concerns applications, as I said, quantization comes from electrical engineering and information theory. And in the meantime, there are many applications in numerical probability, a lot of them by Jill. And yesterday we heard something about the role of quantizers in as covariates in the variance reduction methods. And also there are recently many recursive schemes for models where we have a time discretization, starting also from Jill's papers, like models like SDEs, BSDEs, McKean-Vlasov equations. And I guess tomorrow we will see another example by Giorgia Calegaro. Several surveys are due to Jill. So non-asymptotic bounds and the sharp asymptotics of the quantization errors. Here, radial functions on cones play an important role. So let K be a closed convex cone in RD. A positive function is said to have radial decreasing tails on K, abbreviated by RT, if there exists some eta positive and a norm such that for every x, the complement of this zero norm ball with radius eta intersected with a cone K, we have this representation, every x is the G of the zero norm of x, where G is the decree. And R means that eta is zero. And then we have the following non-asymptotic universal bounds. Let F be any Lebesgue density satisfying radiality R on a cone. And assume that the support of P is contained in this cone. Then for every n, the LR minimal quantization error is upper bounded by a constant C times the integral of F to the minus R over D with respect to P, then the R root times the standard rate N to the minus 1 over D. So, of course, this is reasonable only if this integral is finite. C is universal in the sense that it does not depend on P. And the cone condition, for instance, includes one-sided one-dimensional distributions. Then you can obtain a sharp asymptotic result. Assume that 1 over f is in this LRD space with respect to P for some Lebesgue density up to norming, satisfying the radial tail condition on some cone. Assume the support of P is contained in this cone. And then the limits of n to the 1 over d times the minimal quantization errors exists and is finite. And the limit consists of two parts. This h is the density of the absolutely continuous part of P. And this geometric part, qrd, only depends on d and the norm, and r, of course, and concerns the minimal quantization errors of the uniform distribution on the unit cube. Here the limit is finite because of the previous theorem. And these geometric coefficients, these geometric quantization coefficients, are not known in most cases. However, there are rather good bounds. The quantization coefficients, the geometric quantization coefficients, are known in case d equal to 1, and also in case d equal to 2, if the underlying norm is a L2 norm. And in this case, this QR2, dimension 2, coincides with a normalized S moment over a regular hexagon. And this explains a bit the occurrence of the hexagons in the previous pictures. And this theorem is called shadow theorem because the first result of this type for arbitrary dimensions is contained in Shadow's PhD thesis from the 1960s. And also, if the absolute continuous part of P is zero, then this limit is zero. That means that in this singular case, the quantization errors, the minimal quantization errors, go to zero faster than 1 to the minus 1 over d. Now, one can choose special radial functions. Here is a bit exotic one. In the shell condition, one chooses, say, A1 is the ball with radius 4, say, and then AK, the sets AK are differences of balls with radius 2 to the K, and further assume that there exists a decreasing sequence of positive numbers such that this series is convergent and this is also convergent, which corresponds to these integrability conditions. And then the sharp result 1 holds true. This is 1. It's a choice of f is given here. It's a radial function of the whole RD. The moment condition, so recall that everything is under the condition that x to the r dp is finite. P has finite as moment. And the Mohm condition here says that the x norm to the r times log x norm to the r over d plus some small arbitrary small delta is finite. Then again, the strong limit relation one holds true. And here the choice of f is this one. It's a radial function, of course. And one can say that concerning this log term, that's the best possible exponent. So this type of assumptions is best possible concerning the log term. And I mentioned this shell condition because it's more general than this condition. So this condition, the Mohm condition, sorry, the Mohm condition implies the shell condition. And if the density of P itself satisfies the radial tail condition, then we have these sharp asymptotics without any further integrability conditions. The limit may be infinite. So if H is in this LD over D plus R space, then one chooses as F this point density. And if H is not in this space, then this is infinite, and this is also true. And one may say that the distribution is Euler-Chadow distribution. If the absolutely continuous part is not zero, if the rth moment is finite, and if this sharp relation holds with a limit strictly positive and finite. And this corollary says that that in case the density has radial tails, that's the best possible Chadow type theorem. Oops. Because then it's a necessary and sufficient condition for distribution to be a Chadow distribution. So the next issue, I will investigate the geometry of optimal quantizers. And I will identify the limit of scaled versions of these quantizers in the Hausdorff metric for compact non-empty subsets. This is the Hausdorff metric. And then let for every n, let gamma n be LR optimal for P. And here's a case of radial exponential tails. Assume that P has a density, where the density satisfies the radial tail condition on the cone. Assume that the support of P is contained in this cone. And the radial tail condition means that H can be written as a function G of the norm. So assume G is strictly positive. And minus log G is regularly varying at infinity with index theta. Theta strictly positive, I guess. So it means f behaves like roughly like x to the theta. Let f tilde denote an asymptotic inverse of f, where this means that the feature of being an inverse holds only up to strong equivalence. And then this scaled version of gamma n, of the quantizers gamma n, converges in the Hausdorff metric to this zero norm ball intersected with the cone K. And you see that here in this geometric discussion, the scaling heavily depends on the distribution. That's in contrast to the former results, where the rate was always n to the minus 1 over d. And since the radius functional is continuous in the Hausdorff metric, one obtains that the radius of a sequence of optimal quantizers, of n optimal quantizers, is strongly equivalent to the radius of this Born intersective is k times f tilde d plus r over d log n. And here one can mention that this inner rate is strongly equivalent to the increments of quantization errors on a log scale. And also it improves the understanding of optimal quantizers, seeing it as a benchmark result, for instance, and it may serve to construct a starting grids for quantization algorithms. And for specific distributions like the Gaussian distributions, one can improve the result. So let P be a Gaussian with regular matrix, covariance matrix. This is density. The zero norm is this norm, where this should read cap sigma. And then even the Hausdorff distance between gamma n itself and this scaled ball goes to zero at this rate. And one can mention that if the underlying norm is a L2 norm, then the radius of this ball is the square root of the largest eigenvalue of sigma. So the radius is under the underlying norm. It's the radius on the underlying norm. That's the ball in the zero norm ball. So here is a normal distribution in the plane with eigenvalues 1 and 1 over 4. And there are two ellipses. The inner one is U, the misprint here, that's U means this zero norm unit ball, scaled with the radius of gamma n. That's the inner ellipse, and the outer ellipse, there's a scaling this theoretical radius. And you see that I guess all quantizers are in the outer ellipse and almost all up to some exceptions are in the inner ellipse. So for n equal to 1000, you see that all quantizers are lying in the outer ellipse and nearly all in the inner. And the theory says that the Hausdorff distance of both ellipses goes to zero. In case that the density itself is regularly varying with index minus theta less than minus d plus r, then we have a less precise result. Consider this function 1 over g times d to the d plus r. Consider the asymptotic inverse, and then the radius is weakly equivalent to k tilde n to the d plus r over d. Weak equivalence means that the lim-inf is strictly positive, lim-sup is finite. An example is the T distribution. And here, important contributions are due to former PhD students Stefan Junglin and Abbas Sanyan. So the next and probably final question is, can random quantizers compete with optimal quantizers? And roughly the answer is no, if the dimension is small, and yes, if dimension D is large. So consider ID variables y1, y2, etc. with distribution Q. Consider this random codebook, and then the error of this random codebook is given as usual by these integrals. The mean L error is the expectation, or the LR norm of this error. And of course, one can use random quantizers as starting values for algorithms. And then the question is, how small is the initial distortion? One can check that in case P is dominated by the absolutely continuous part of Q, that's in some sense a minimal condition, then n to the 1 over d times the minimal distance of x minus yi's goes in distribution to some probability u, which is a scale mixture of Weibull distributions with this distribution function. And hence, of course, the liminf of the rth moment is larger than or equal to the rth moment of nu. This can be computed, and it's given by the volume of the ball to the minus r over d gamma function at 1 plus r over d, this integral f to the minus r over d. And if we imagine for a moment that we have equality here, then we can try to compare this limit with the optimal one from the Schneider theorem. And the comparison of this factor with the geometric quantization coefficient looks like this. It's less than gamma at 2 plus r over d. And if d goes to infinity, this goes to 1. And this integral is minimized by the point density, hr. So that it means optimal random quantizers should be based on samples from the point density measure. And you see here the minimal conditions for this, for here to be equality, is that the rth moment of x and y are finite, and that this integral is finite. And under a slightly stronger condition, this is in fact true. Consider the Hardy-Littlebrook maximal function phi q given by this soup over these ratios. D is running from 0 to the norm of x plus 1. And then assume that we have finite m times r moments of p and q. And we assume that the max function phi q is lying in L r d with respect to p. This replaces the condition that 1 over f is lying in this space. And then we have for m equal to 1 that this expectation converges. And if m is 2 or larger, then we have convergence of the random, of the errors of the random sample in Lm space. This is in some sense the best possible one can get. And if m is equal to 2, for instance, we get convergence in L2, that means we get convergence in probability. And in fact, if we had, we add some delta, that means if you assume that the moment of the order 2r plus delta is finite, that phi q lies in LR plus delta, over D. And we assume a finite delta energy of P. Then we arrive at almost true convergence. And this is also the best possible up to delta, the best possible version one can get up to delta. This assumption is not very strong. It's satisfied if H is in some LP space with P larger than one. And this is based on contributions by former PhD student Pierre Cohor, but we optimized all integrability assumptions. So I think I will stop here. Thank you very much.